Hello, I'm Dr. Ron Engelman, and hopefully you're noticing that there is a soccer ball floating around the screen right here. Yeah, that's because I'm going to show you some animation. That's what I'm going to do here. And I'm going to show you animation, and this specific example is just using jQuery. We are going to look at some different animation capabilities of different things, because in the class, the COP4813, you're going to be doing some animation and game programming in JavaScript. But let's look at basic animation right now. Now, as you can see, this is a soccer ball. It's animated. And we can go up here, and you can actually see that this is just an IMG tag embedded in a div. And it's important that this is embedded into a div, with the in this case, the class ball, because the jQuery animate procedure or a function really only supports embedded elements embedded in a div. In other words, I can't animate the ball directly, but I can animate the div that is surrounding the ball, which is a major limitation of what you can do with animation inside of jQuery, which is why we're going to look at some other different types of animation packages. But this is pretty good to get you the basic concepts of animation. So if you look at this, I'm going to look at the CSS and look at the actual class ball. It's got an absolute position with a top, a left, a width, and a height. And the ball has a width and a height also. So you can see that those all are all there. But let's look at specifically what's causing this animation. Now, in this case, the animation is based on using the timer, the JavaScript timer. And the timer is really a useful thing. So what the timer is going to do in this specific instance here is I set the timer interval equal to 100. That's just a variable. Okay. And here, I create a timer by using window.setInterval. And what setInterval does, it allows you to define a function that gets called every time that time interval clicks by. So the timer interval, which is in this case 100, which is 0.1 seconds, is going to call the function. Now I do have a way to stop this. I'm going to click stop because I actually did create a stop button. And the stop button just clears the interval. That's it right here, clear interval. But let's look and see what happens here. So every 100 milliseconds, the function ball timer gets called. That's what this window.setInterval does. So let's go down here to this move ball. And that's really going to get you into the concepts of the animation. Well, the first thing that I want to do is I need to figure out where it is. So I've created a variable left and a variable top. Inside the HTML screen, you've got two variables that you have access to, left and top. And what I do is I say object, obj is the actual object being passed to this function. If you look at the ball timer, it uses the jQuery selector dot ball, which finds the div element ball. Dot ball is a div element, and it passes that to move ball. So move ball, I don't care what gets passed to move ball, it's an object as far as I'm concerned at this point, but it has an offset left and an offset top. And I get those using the offset function of the object itself, and then left and top. Now, I'm going to go ahead and animate this. To animate it, I've got to have a move duration. So in other words, I'm going to tell it to move, and I also need to tell it how long do I need it to take to move from one position to another. Now, what I've done here with this is I do set the, I have another div on the page where I'm actually putting over here the left and top position so I can see it. Not necessarily needed. It has nothing to do with the animation, but it's something that lets me see what the ball is actually doing. Now here's the animation itself. I check to see where it is on the left and where it is to the top. And in the case of the left is less than 250 and the top is less than equal to 100, I know that I'm going to move it to the right. So I have the object here and I call the animate function on this, and the animate function has lots of properties and lots of things that you can pass to it. In this case, I'm going to pass to it to increment the left by 10 pixels and do it over the duration of 50 milliseconds, which is that 50 that I set right here, move duration. So it takes 50 milliseconds to move it. Then return. I'm done. if the left is greater than or equal to 50 and the top is greater than or equal to 250, okay, I'm going to go back the other direction. I'm going to take the left and I'm going to move it back. That's the minus equals. So that's your left and right motion. Your top and bottom motion is actually controlled by that top variable. And so if the left is greater than 250 and the top is less than equal to 250, I increment the top. And down here, I decrement the top. So in other words, I've essentially defined a path that is a square. So if I hit run, I've got this increment and decrement, and this is the offset shown right here. It shows where the offset position is, and using that left and top offsets, I can tell the ball to follow a specific path, which is in this case a square. And I did it using the animate function built into jQuery of an object, remembering that the limitation of this animate is it has to be an element that can be wrapped inside of a div. That's it for this part of animation. We're going to do a lot more with animation in the future, and we are going to be using some different packages. But this in itself should show you what it takes to actually get something to move on a screen. Thank you very much. Good programming.